Would you like to have better energy moving through your body? It's actually very, very simple. If you want perfect health, the two most important things to have perfect health are moving energy through your body and being relaxed. I asked all my friends, what do you want most in your life? And the answer always comes up to be health, happiness, and being able to live a useful life and be a useful member of our society. So what are the things that are the most important for our health? Well, we've got to have a healthy body, being able to move in a pain-free, useful way. That's important. That's our physical health. We need to also have physiological health, good energy levels, good blood flow, good internal health. And we've also got to have a good mental health as well. So how can we do this? I think the most important thing is to be able to move good energy and loving information through our bodies. We need to have a sound physical structure. That's important, obviously, but also to have healthy blood flow through our bodies, which I call good energy, and also healthy nervous system, which I'll call loving information. So what is good energy and loving information flowing through our bodies? Well, we need to have healthy blood flow, but often people overdo it by thinking it's important to get your heart rate up. Whereas actually what we really want is to have good circulation, but heart rate has to be kept slow or kept low. And a lot of people really put a lot too much emphasis on getting the heart rate up, whereas what we really want is just healthy circulation. Healthy circulation is one of the most important pillars for having good energy in your life, and it's also important for long-term health. But if you do this with the heart rate increased, that's just part of your stress response. So what we want is to have healthy blood flow while remaining completely calm. So is that possible to have healthy blood flow, increased blood flow while staying calm? The answer is yes. And what are the secrets to getting improved blood flow while staying calm? Well, there's two most important things. The two most important things you need to do for ongoing health are to, one, improve blood flow in your body, and two, improve the state of your nervous system so you have a dominance of that relaxed, happy, healthy mode, which we call the parasympathetic dominant state. And to do this, the two most important things you need to do are stop blocking healthy blood flow, and number two is encourage healthy blood flow. So what stops the flow of healthy blood through your body is too much tension, too much inappropriate postures, including too much stretching, too much breathing inappropriately especially, too much thinking, and too much eating. So my motto generally is tense less, stretch less, breathe less, think less, and eat less. It sounds a bit crazy to say tense your muscles less. We want to get stronger, but can you do it without feeling tense? The answer is yes. Can you become more flexible without stretching? The answer is yes. Stretch is not a good feeling. Stretch is a feeling that your body is unable to go any further. It's a loss of freedom. Stretch usually is part of your stretch reflex, which is part of your flight or fight response. Is there a way of becoming more flexible without the feeling of stretching? The answer is yes. Breathing more than normal is what sick people do. Can you run faster without breathing so much? Can you run faster without having your heart having to race so much? Well, if you can, you're called fit. If you walk slowly and you breathe more and you make your heart beat more when you're walking slowly, That's called unfitness. It's called ill health. So is there a way of doing more exercise while breathing less? The answer is yes. It's an expression of fitness. And can you do a more intense, complex activity without having to think so much? The answer is yes, if you're one with that activity. It's called the meditative state. It's called the flow state or the zone in terms of athletics, in terms of sports fitness. And can you actually have more energy while eating less food? The answer is yes, if you're able to absorb your food better, eliminate waste better, and actually metabolize your food in a way where you create more energy for less, using less fuel. The secret to doing that is in how you metabolize your fuel. And the secret to that is, can you metabolize your fuel, your food, the glucose, especially inside your body, using more oxygen to burn? How do you get more oxygen inside your cells? You get more oxygen inside your cells by breathing less, not by breathing more. The more you breathe, the less oxygen gets into your cells. This is basic physiology. If you breathe too much, called hyperventilation, you will actually reduce the flow of oxygen to your brain, reduce the flow of blood to your brain, because the over-breathing causes a loss of carbon dioxide in your body. It depletes your carbon dioxide levels. Carbon dioxide is not our enemies. It's what helps the trees. So when you breathe more than normal, you blow off your carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide, in its absence, will cause a reduced blood flow to the brain, meaning less oxygen to the brain, less energy for your brain. You'll feel tired. You'll feel listless. You'll feel tense or stressed, because carbon dioxide in its presence keeps your nervous system calm. In its absence makes your nervous system stressed. It'll make you feel jittery. It will increase pain. Carbon dioxide in its presence opens the tubes in your lungs, which will increase the flow of oxygen from your lungs to your blood. But in its absence, when you breathe too much, will give you asthma and less entry of oxygen to your blood. Carbon dioxide, when it's present, will allow the entry of oxygen from the oxyhemoglobin. The red blood cells carry oxygen on a molecule called oxyhemoglobin. But that oxygen is not able to be released unless you have sufficient amounts of carbon dioxide, which will be there if you breathe just the right amount. But if you breathe more than normal, more than natural breathing offers, then you'll actually restrict the flow of oxygen from your red blood cells into your body cells. And when there's not enough oxygen in your cells, because there's not enough carbon dioxide in your blood, then every glucose molecule will not be able to produce enough energy. If you burn or metabolize a glucose molecule in the absence of oxygen, which is called anaerobic metabolism, you'll create two molecules of ATP, which is the energy source of the cells. But if you can get oxygen to be burnt or metabolized in the presence of oxygen, if glucose can be burnt or metabolized in the presence of oxygen, then you get 38 molecules of ATP, 18 times as much energy just by bringing oxygen into your cells. How do you bring oxygen into your cells? By having enough carbon dioxide. How do you create enough carbon dioxide? By restoring natural breathing. And if you can restore the natural breathing that you have when you were a child, or that you still maybe have when you're asleep, you get better oxygen. Breathing naturally is the key. And once you can master breathing naturally, or remaster the natural breathing that you had as a child, that you might get in your deeper sleep, if you're actually getting good sleep, which is very important, then I can show you how to do supernatural breathing. And supernatural breathing is the breath that the yogis of Tibet and India and China and all traditional cultures, including the indigenous cultures of Australia, South America, Africa, and all over the world, have done to have supernatural abilities. Like being able to survive in the cold, to survive with much less food, to be able to be meditative, calm, and lead a long, happy, healthy life. I can show you some of the secrets I've learned from the great masters that I've learned with. The mastering of your breath is only possible if you can restore natural breathing first. What's natural breathing? It's five things. Inhale low in your pelvic floor, lower back, lower abdomen. Exhale passively with no extra tension. Don't breathe so much. You can forget the breath and get on with your normal activities and breathe through your nose. If you can learn these things, remaster the things you do in your deepest sleep, in your everyday activities, especially when you're moving your whole body. This is the first step to natural health, to restoring better health. Thank you.